There is this interesting article that I found online, and it says scientists prove DNA can be reprogrammed by words and frequencies. Metaphysical and spiritual community already knew that, but for science to verify what we already knew is really a big game changer, because people will be more open to affirmations and even things like hypnosis and you know, putting affirmations backwards. So let me just start. It says that, well, you know how they say that 10% of the DNA is only used to build proteins, and the rest is junk DNA. Well, what they found out is, of course, we all knew this, that the junk DNA is not really junk. It's actually a way of communicating. So it says, according to them, our DNA is not only responsible for the construction of our body, but also serves as a storage of communication. So we can communicate through those parts that they used to call the junk DNA, to reprogram our bodies and even to communicate with others. It says here, one can simply use words and sentences of a human language. This too was experimentally proven. Living DNA substance in living tissues, not in vitro, will always react to language, modulated laser rays, and even to radio waves if the proper frequencies are being used. So just imagine that you have a big influence on how your body reacts to, let's say, certain sicknesses. You can change that through or circumstances in your life. You can change that through frequencies and different affirmations. There are different frequencies that you can use for certain things, and I will see if I can find it, but I'll put that in the description of what you can use these different different sequences for different things in your life. It says, while Western researchers cut single genes from the DNA strands and insert them elsewhere, the Russians enthusiastically worked on devices that can influence the cellular metabolism through suitable modulated radio and light frequencies, thus repair genetic defects. I mean, if you just paid attention to that sentence, you can actually repair genetic defects. The only drawback of this, if we can do that positively to our bodies, imagine all those that don't have great intentions, what they can do to us. So it's best that we take a proactive measures to make sure that the frequencies that we have, or the majority of the frequencies that we bring into our lives, are good frequencies, and the majority of the words that come into our lives are words that will help us repair and replenish our lives, or even bring it up to a higher level. So continuing, it says, research group succeeded to prove that with this method, chromosome damage by x-rays, for example, can be repaired. They even captured information patterns of a particular DNA and transmitted it into another, thus reprogramming cells to another genome. So they successfully transformed, for example, frog embryos to salamander embryos simply by transmitting the DNA information patterns. This way, the entire information was transmitted without any of the side effects or disharmonious encounters when cutting out and reintroducing the single genes from the DNA. This represents an unbelievable world transforming revolution and sensation. All this by simply applying vibration and language instead of the archaic cutout procedures. This experiment points to immense power of wave genetics, which obviously has a greater influence on the information of organisms that the biochemical process of alkaline sequences. So, I mean, we've known this a long time, but you really don't have to cut the body and take out the things that are supposedly bad. You can actually heal the body without cutting things out or being invasive to the body. And this proves that science actually is proving it here. So it says researchers think that if humans with full individuality would regain group consciousness, they could have a godlike power to create, alter, and shape things on Earth and humanity. It's collectively moving towards such a group consciousness of a new kind. For example, they had, I'm not sure if you guys are aware of this experiment, but they had a group of people meditate for I don't have the exact story, but for a group of days, a number of days, and I think it was in Chicago, and the crime rate of Chicago went down, and they've done this in other places too. It says whenever a great many people focus their attention or consciousness on something similar, like Christmas time, football world championships, or funeral of Lady Diana in England, then certain random number generators in computers start to deliver ordered numbers instead of random ones. An ordered group consciousness creates order in its whole surrounding. Again, you know, this could be a positive and negative thing. So, you know, you need to be careful what you bring into your consciousness. If you're watching, you know, a lot of news that just brings fear to your heart, or you just don't want to take chances because you saw something that might that could happen to you, and in the same way, collectively, we don't enhance our environment when we're constantly thinking of fear in an individual way or in a collective consciousness. Says when a great number of people get together, very close potentials of violence is dissolved. It looks as if here too a kind of humanitarian consciousness of all humanity is created. To come back to the DNA, it apparently is also an organic superconductor that can work at normal body temperature. Artificial superconductors require extremely low temperatures of between 200 and 140 Celsius to function. As one certainly learned, all superconductors are able to store light and thus information. This is a further explanation of how the DNA can store information. There is another phenomenon linked to DNA and wormholes. Normally, these small, super small wormholes are highly unstable and are maintained only for the tiniest fractions of seconds. Under certain conditions, stable wormholes can organize themselves, which then form distinct vacuum domains in which, for example, gravity can transform into electricity. So there's so many unlimited potentials that you can have with those, what they used to call junk DNA. When you are consuming, for example, music or even watching a movie, be conscious of how that might end up changing your DNA or altering your DNA. I know for sure in movies there is this, if you guys can notice that usually when it's exciting times during the movie, you hear beep 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 beep. Watch it if you're ever watching a movie and it's exciting. Stop focusing on exactly the movie, but focus on the music that is being put during the movie, and you'll hear like this beeping sound during the movie. And what I've read is that frequency right there alters your brain. I remember we were watching a marathon of Flash, and after I finished watching the marathon of Flash, I went to meditate, and for some reason I could not meditate. Like my brain was jumping around everywhere, so I went into the heart and in my brain, and I almost dissected my brain, and I saw that the middle of the brain, which they call the midbrain, was shaky. It was unstable. I did a few things to correct that, but that is how they can also manipulate our DNA and alter our state of mind. So I just wanted to share this article with you guys, and know that you guys have the power and the potential to change things in your life, not only outside, but also inside, all the way to your DNA. Again, thank you for watching, and I will definitely see you in the next video.